Tonight, the nation is reeling as the death toll climbs. Just hours ago, the administration said the virus could claim more than 200,000 lives.
This is going to be a very painful, very, very painful 2 weeks.
Dr. Anthony Fauci asking for the public's cooperation.
Let's all pull together and make sure, as we look forward to the next 30 days, we do it with all the intensity and force that we can.
Dr. Deborah Birx.
There's no magic bullet. There's no magic vaccine or therapy. It's just behaviors.
From coast to coast, an escalating crisis. NBC's Stephanie Gosk.
In the last few weeks, Dr. Calvin Sun, an emergency room doctor, has worked in a dozen New York City hospitals over 18 shifts.
Now we're bursting at the seams, and it just seems that the system is about to collapse.
Once again, the New York metropolitan area is ground zero. This time, not for an act of terror, but for this pandemic, which has instilled fear and horror just the same.
This is New York as we've never known it.
NBC's Ann Thompson.
What makes this so different is that you cannot see this enemy, but you know it's there.
The rate of infections is exploding, as is the death toll. In just 6 hours Monday, 124 people died in New York City alone. Calls to the city's 911 system have set records for days, and first responders are overwhelmed. NBC investigative reporter Tom Winter.
The New York metropolitan area is going through an unprecedented public health and first responder crisis all at once. You have tens of thousands of cases.
Hospitals are desperately trying to respond.
So why don't we get started?
Each morning, Dr. Thomas McGinn of New York's Northwell Health System conducts a conference call with 200 physicians. So far, he thinks they're holding their own, but he's not sure for how long.
As I continue to repeat, to everybody, the center of the storm is New York City, and Northwell is at the center of that storm.
And in its wake, scenes no one would believe just a few weeks ago. There's now a temporary hospital set up in Central Park. It opened today. One father and son team are in the vortex of the pandemic emergency. Dr. Irwin Redlener is an NBC News analyst whose youngest son is a New York doctor.
You know, basically going to battle every day when he goes to work.
Dr. Redlener is an acclaimed pediatrician and disaster preparedness expert who's witnessed countless tragedies.
But even that doesn't really compare to the emotional toll that it takes to have a child on that front line at this particular time.
His son, Dr. Michael Redlener, is associate medical director in the emergency room at Mount Sinai West Hospital in Manhattan.
I'm worried about my safety as well. You know, he's been teaching me my whole life that it's important to contribute to society.
It's March 27th, 2020.
For a few days, he's recorded his observations at the end of his shift. He spoke of a colleague, a nurse, who died from the virus.
We were working side by side a couple of nights ago, so it's a hard thing to understand that we're losing people already.
I think we're all a bit shocked about what this is doing to our lives. I mean, it's not just, you know, taxing the medical system, it's taxing all of us.
And then, tonight, the Redlener family informed us that their other son, Michael's older brother, who's 52, has been hospitalized with coronavirus. But there are some brighter spots in these dark times. In Teaneck, New Jersey, at the hard-hit Holy Name Medical Center, the CEO was diagnosed with coronavirus. But this week, Michael Maron was able to return to work.
So they all very happy to see me back, to know that this disease doesn't win all the time. And now I'm walking, living proof of that.